Hello student, how are you all? Student, today in this video we are going to start chapter number 10 part 1 of English and the name of chapter is Malu Bhalu. Student, you all knows now it is the time of winter and it is extreme cold. But have you ever thought that what will be the temperature on the places like Alaska and Antarctica, which are totally covered by ice? Do you think life will be possible there? But student, there is one animal who is living in such an extreme temperature. They are polar bears. Student, so this poem is also about bears. Let's see. High up in icy layer lived a little polar bear. Snow white, snow bright was her mane. Malu Bhalu was her name. The poet says that high up on a icy mountain there lived a one polar bear with her family, and that polar bear was very white like snow, and the mane means a hair on her neck was also bright like snow, and the name of that bear was Malu Bhalu. Actually Bhalu is an Hindi word where bears are called Bhalu in Hindi, and Malu is the name of that bear. Very soon our Malu Bhalu learned the things her parents knew. Fish to catch, big and small. Malu was a clever girl. The poet says that Malu Bhalu was a very clever girl, and she had started learning the things from her parents, like how to catch the big or small fishes. She learned everything very fast, whatever the parents taught her, as she was a very clever girl. Malu said to her mother one day, "Ma, I am going far out to play. I want to see the things that lie there beyond the big blue sky." A little patient child said, "Mum, in the summer when next it comes." Summer, patient, what a test. Malu simply could not rest. One day, Malu said to her mother that she is going out to play to the faraway places because she want to see each and everything that is beyond this big blue sky, means she want to see all the things that is under the sky. Then her mother said that you please have some patience, and when will be the time of summer, when the next summer comes, then you go and see all the things, not now. On hearing her mother, Malu thought that waiting till summer or having a patient, that is a very big difficult test. And on thinking about this, visiting the different places and waiting till the summer, thinking all this thing again and again, she could not rest. First things first, Malu's mom clasped Malu tight within her arms. Then she said, her voice was frail, "Now my dear, you have to swim." Then the mother bear said to Malu that first things first means the first thing you have to learn is to swim. Then she rolled his both the hands or both the arms around the Malu and given her a one tight hug, and she said in a very loving voice that Now it is the time that you have to learn to swim. But Ma, said Malu, what do I knew? How will I have never swum before. Don't worry, dear, said Malu's mother. Do as I do, that's all, she advised her. Then Malu said, how would I swim? I had never swimmed before. I don't know anything about swimming. Malu was little worried on hearing her mother. Then the mother said that, don't worry, dear. You just follow me and do what I do. Then all the things will be very easy and you will learn everything. This was the advice given by her mother to Malu. She had no choice, no other way. Malu has to swim that day. Tight she grips her mother's hand into the water slap to land. Then poet says that Malu had no choice that day because mother has already decided that today she has to learn swimming. So Malu has no other choice or no other way to escape from that. So what she did? She had hold her mother's hand very tightly. And she became brave and then with her mother, she slipped into the water from the land. And now they both were in water. Brave young daughter, doubts and fears she left behind her. Malu swam with her whole might. She didn't matter wrong or right. The poet says that brave mother's brave young daughter. She left her all the doubts and fear behind her and then she trusted her mother and started swimming. She swam with her whole heart without thinking whether it is wrong or right. She just trusted her mother and started swimming in the water. She was not knowing whether she was doing that was correct or not, but she swam with all her heart. But swimming comes so naturally. Her mother knew this and all could see. Fearless was Malu. This is she knew, not just brave but special too. In the last paragraph, the poet says that Malu's swimming comes naturally as she was living in the area where she needs to or she is habited to do this. So her swimming comes naturally and her mother also knew that she will learn very fast or that swimming will comes naturally. After that experience, Malu become fearless and her mother said that you are not only brave but you are a very special to me. Okay, student. So this was the poem and in the next video we will see the chapter. Thank you.